Ladies and gentlemen, Victorian Cowboy here, and today we are going to start our playthrough of Fallout 4 for all you lovely people out there listening. So, we are going to start a new game. Yes, we will start a new game. I have played about 12 hours of this, 13 hours of this, on a different character, but I'm going to be playing something, or doing something that I haven't done before, which is actually basing my character into a specific field, because usually I just play whatever I feel like playing, usually small one-handed weapons and whatnot. So we're going to be actually creating ourselves a scientist, a very charismatic, intelligent scientist with a little bit of luck, though not going to be super strong. Okay, we've got this opening cutscene here. It's pretty cool. No, it doesn't. It's still people pointing guns at each other and killing each other, when in reality, all we should do is stop and talk. We sit down and talk without having to kill a bunch of people. We would be a lot better off.
Wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II. By dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
Now, I do like the fact that this game, you actually have a voice. Like, having a voice for your character, I just feel like it works this time. Plus, a lot of the companions you can get along the way are a lot of fun. Energy not as a weapon,
but it's a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction.
Oh, and there's Mr. Handy. I love Mr. Handy. Cars, portable computers. That is a very large Pip-Boy there. But then, that's the first one.
In the 21st century.
Scale it down a little bit, we'd be better off.
People awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource.
Oh, yeah. Shortages, climate change, all that good stuff. To war.
Peace became a distant memory.
We're back on the forefront of war.
It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war.
That's not too far away.
I am afraid.
Not too far away.
For myself. For my wife. For my infant son.
Power armor. Regular armor. Laser weapons!
It's that war.
War never changes.
War never changes.
No, it doesn't. Personally, I prefer to be the guy in the power armor there, just because if we get ambushed, he's the one who's going to survive the longest. You get ambushed there? Alright. So, time to create ourselves a character.
War. Changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Hey there in the background.
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Isn't that the constant struggle, even in 2077? So.
Hey, my turn, big guy.
Let's see what we come up with here. So. Nope. That one works for me. Let's just take a look and see what we can determine. Let's see what styles we've got in female hair. New. That one's not bad. Well, Windy the Welder isn't a bad idea either. So let's see. What hairstyle do we want to do? We've got, seeing as we'll be running around the wasteland, some of these are just absurd. I think we'll go with the one it started with. Well, no, I like that one. It's a little, less. Let's see, anything else I want? No. So we'll escape back. Let's see what extras we can add. Do we want makeup?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that works.
if we remove it, what does that look like? No, we like the lipstick. But actually, we're gonna look really good fighting the wasteland there. Let's see, damn it. No, she wasn't the soldier. She's a scientist. Yeah, so that was relatively simple for us to find something. But let's look at body type. There we go. That's a little better. And we'll be done here. There we go. We have a character. Oh, we got a little bun in the back too. That's a nice touch. His name is Nate. Really?
Ah, good morning,
Bob. Hey, Cotsworth. Nice to see you again. Drinking the coffee.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies.
Jungle of the Bat Babies, huh? Where's paper? What am I doing now? Can't remember what I'm doing.
Cotsworth?
Enjoy your coffee, Mum.
I already drank the coffee. Now what?
Hey, hon.
We should take Cotsworth to be serviced soon, don't you think?
More of the same.
Let's see.
Oh, sounds like someone made a sticky.
Go on, Cotsworth. Go take care of the baby.
I know we were nervous at first, but I'm glad we got Cotsworth.
Cotsworth is awesome. Vault-Tec is out there. What am I supposed to be doing?
Hey, hon.
I can't believe it's almost Halloween. I need to finish making Sean's costume.
What am I waiting for? Let's play with the baby for a minute.
Ah, chores and more chores. My endless chores.
Let's spin the mobile. Oh, there we go.
Why he keeps bothering you.
Let's come and look at the salesman. Had to wait for him to come.
Good morning.
Here we go, Vault-Tec guy.
Good morning.
Isn't it?
She looks quite thrilled to have this here.
You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
I'm here now.
So you are. So you are.
Oh, dear me. This guy just seems so... I don't know how I'd describe him, but he's quite a piece of work.
I'm here today to tell you that because of...
Yay. Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for...
Let's get in here.
...unforeseen event of...
Total Atomic Annihilation.
I just need to verify.
All right, let's get this information filled out.
Sure, let's do it.
Splendid. Splendid.
You seem real thrilled about that now. So, name. Now, the reason I'm naming this character Rosa Franklin is Rosalind Franklin was one of the inventors, or one of the people who really helped discover DNA as we know it today. And so I feel like it's a brilliant idea to play a character who's a scientist and give some love to some of the unsung heroes of science as far as we know it. Okay, what should we go with? Perception. So you've got charisma, intelligence, and a little bit of luck, perception. Let's accept that. Marvelous! I have no clue how well this is going to work out for us, but I'm hoping it's okay. Slam the door in his face.
Peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
Sure.
Price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Okay, time to go deal with the with the baby. So, the reason I named her Rosa, though, is because Rosalind doesn't get pronounced by Codsworth, but Rosa will. Why don't you give it a spin? Spin the mobile. The mobile is spinning.
That's
your
boy,
special.
His best behavior, just like his dad.
Mm-hmm.
Well, most of the time. Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, except for it's a nuclear winter.
Oh, right. The park. With you. Because I want to get pregnant again.
Okay. Oh, dear me.
What's wrong?
I had not used that answer before, but hey. We got some sassy friskiness going on.
Flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions.
Codsworth, what did you do? Don't blow up the world.
You seem to have lost contact with
what did he say?
Stations.
Oh no.
We do have coming in. That's
okay.
Confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear.
Well, we are at war.
Pennsylvania.
So time to run. Time to run.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
Which way is the vault? Vault's this way. Come on. Why are there tanks here, though? Like, did they just anticipate this and the tanks showed up? Come on. Come on. Stop arguing, people, and get there. Come on. You're so slow, man. Weren't you in the army? You should be in better shape. Oh, look, the mailman's coming too. Spectacular. To the gate.
I am
not on the list. You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop me. Don't shoot.
Hey,
I'm reporting this.
If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return.
We need to get in.
Good lord, that guy's got a minigun.
Infant.
I didn't see that last time I played this.
Adult female.
And then that laser rifle just looks tiny in that guy's arms. That's kind of comical. Let's move it, people. Up onto the platform. Into the center of the platform. Come on, dude, you got the baby. Get it moving. We're gonna go down.
He's fine. We're gonna be okay.
We'll be fine.
Oh,
we'll meet again. Don't know where. Don't know when. But darling, we'll meet again. And there's a bunch of radiation that came down with that lovely blast. But we're fine. We're fine. You know, it's all good. There's nothing to worry about. Nothing to worry about. We're gonna be okay.
We did it.
Yep, we made it all right.
We made it. We're okay.
Although you aren't exactly dressed.
Elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion. No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home.
Vault 111.
111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
Up the stairs.
If we left a minute later...
We
no,
made
we don't.
It.
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now.
Let's see what the vault has to offer.
Please proceed in an orderly fashion.
This one's good.
Step over to the table, take a seat.
I'll take the clothes.
Look now. Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
There's a doctor.
Follow me.
I'm over here now.
See?
Come on, man.
This is our new home.
Nuclear annihilation.
This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you. Our home.
But they're not.
Everything we had.
My mother and father down in D.C.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to
get. Oh, okay. Let's go through the medical items and the checks.
Fashionable. As well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
I need myself one of those outfits. And let's just get into these lovely little chambers for decontamination. Let's see how this goes. Because, you know, these don't at all look sketchy. And depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax. Mm-hmm.
A whole new life. Resident secure.
And let's see what happens. Normal vitals, yay! Procedure complete. So it should open up then?
In.
Nope.
Five.
Not opening up.
Four.
We're gonna freeze! This cannot be healthy for a developing baby. That little baby there, across from me, being frozen for God knows how long, not a healthy outcome. No. This is not good for a child. Aye, cryogenics. Are we gonna find Walt Disney next? Oof. What is this?
This is
oh, I thought it was a person's face over there to begin with.
Okay.
That's unfortunate. Hey. Okay. So, Nate, you doing all right over there?
Everything's gonna be fine.
Of course, he comes in with his gun out. Wow, that's a wonderful way to try and save your child stuck in the cryogenic thing. Just, you know, headshot someone. All right, buddy. The backup? Oh, and now my head's at an odd angle. I'm gonna wake up with a crick in my neck, and it's gonna be awful. And I don't know what's gonna happen. Oh, let me out of this machine. Oh, well, somebody heard my pleas to get out. Let's get going. Let me out. Oh, gonna fall out. My legs probably don't work. They're probably asleep from standing for so long.
Come on.
Open it up. Now he's dead. Even though they cryogenically froze him again, he is.
I'll find who did this.
He is dead.
And I'll get Sean back.
Let's find ourselves. And all these people are dead. Everyone's dead. We're the lone survivors of Vault 111. Do I want to? I don't really want to go through all the data again. But I am going to look around and see if I can find any items. Because it being a Fallout game, looting is very important. So you take what you can, and then you run again. Door inaccessible. Yeah, wonderful. I don't have a maintenance representative. Okay, well, that's a giant cockroach. So that's lovely. Do we have anything useful in here? We've got a Stein pack, security terminal, coffee cup, couple of cigarettes, and okay. Well, time to go and smack some roaches around, it seems. Don't have a gun yet. So that makes things slightly more frustrating. Got another security baton if you missed the first one. Die, you roachy McRoacherson. Giant
roaches?
Bugs.
What the hell?
Do we have anything useful in here? Anything useful in here? There's a toaster. Do I want to take the toaster? Nah. Oh, that's been dead for a while. We are going to get in here, though, because I want to take... Can I eject the tape? There we go. We'll take that tape with us. Play it whenever we want. So the cool thing is your Pip-Boy is also pretty much a Game Boy. You can take those lovely little tapes. Oof. Not gonna walk in there. And you can plug them into the Pip-Boy whenever you find it and play them on the go. I've only found the one so far. And we'll just beat that guy down. Shouldn't miss. Were I to miss that, I would have been very upset. And we'll take some meat because.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
Well, judging by the skeletons, I'm gonna go with dead. Oh look, radiation. Yeah, it's lovely. We're gonna take a drink of water. Just get some health back.
Is this all that's left?
Pretty much. Not that there was much here to begin with. Opening evacuation tunnel. Okay. That's going to be helpful. Take some ammo. Oh, I want that thing so badly, but I can't open it yet. What else is around here? There must be something. Well, preserved cigarettes. That'll fetch me some money, I think. Okay, that's it then. Now, let's see what's going to happen out here. Oh, look. We got ourselves some giant roaches. Oh, I hit 1 out of 3. Are you kidding me? I've got to be a better shot than that. Well, I'm a better shot manually than that. Oh, hello. Well, I was a better shot manually than that was letting on. And then I started missing everything but giant cockroaches. Okay. Looks like the future is ugly. The future has a face. And it's an ugly face. Let's open the sliding door. There we go. We got him that time. Any more bugs anywhere? Nope, that's it for the bugs. Oh no, it's not. Okay. They hide. Freaking bug. You leave me alone. We're gonna just... This is not at all creepy, just taking a Pip-Boy off a dead skeleton's arm. And we're gonna flip that up. Lock it in place. And, hey, look at all that dust. Hey, hey, hey. We've got a Pip-Boy now. Let's see how much we can carry without having put that much into, Oh, we can carry 220. Okay, that's not too bad. Now then, let's get the heck out of this creepy dungeon of death. And if you can hear that, there are some dogs going a little wild outside. So do forgive me. I'm not sure whose they are.
Did anyone get out? Am I the only one left?
Yeah, you're the only one left. Welcome to the world of sad and madness. So, we'll just take the security baton and head on out there into the world. Come on, door, open up. and we're gonna go for a ride on this thing. Sunlight! Gotta enjoy the little things, because that's about all you got left. Now, going outside in this, you've got to wonder if that's even a good idea, seeing as you don't know how much time has passed, what year it is, any of the nuclear issues you might be having. Oh. Let's finish this and exit the vault. Now, something I wanted to do that I forgot to is if you save it right there, you can come back and play new characters and change everything you want. Even if you've done through the whole thing. But that way you don't have to replay the intro over and over again when you want to start a new game. So you save it there, you can then go change everything about your character you want, and it's marvelous. Now then, we're going to go up to Sanctuary, our home, and then I think we're going to call it an episode. Well, once we take some of this stuff. Marvelous, marvelous stuff. Always make sure you're checking around for loot, because the loot, you never know what you're going to find. What did I found something. What did I found a Molotov cocktail. Okay. I can use that. Let's come over here, see if there's anything in here. You can sprint now, so that's nice. Hey, we got some cram. Got some bottle caps. Some 10mm rounds, so that's going to be useful. And let's go to Sanctuary. We're gonna run. I think I'm going the right way. Am I going the right way? Let's take. No, I'm not. Should have looked at my map. Should have known better. I've actually never gone out and explored that way. But with my luck, it's gonna be something major that I can't deal with right now. And I don't really want that. So let's get our. Oh, there we go. There's the. There is the. Where is the way? Was that the way out of here and I just took a wrong turn? Good lord. Oh, here we go. It's down and around. I knew I was doing something wrong. Look, skeletons. People got fried just standing here waiting. Wunderbar. Oh, I'll take the flower. Pick the pretty flowers and let's keep moving. What's going on here? Sanctuary. Where's my house? It's my. Oh! It's Codsworth! Let's talk to Codsworth. You look a little worse for wear. Yes, it's really me.
Codsworth, you're still here. So other people could still be alive too.
Well, yep. Of course I'm still here. Surely you didn't think a little radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International.
Well, you know, you got to give it to him. I love Codsworth. Yep.
They killed him.
They killed
him. These things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood.
Well, you'd think, but.
We've had a proper family activity.
But unfortunately.
Perhaps charades. Oh, Sean does so.
Oh, Codsworth, you're going to be in for a rude awakening.
He's gone, goddammit. Someone took him. They stole my baby.
Dingoes ate my baby. That's what it feels like. But we'll find Sean somewhere in here. I don't know what's happened to him, but we'll find him.
Doesn't matter how long it's been. I feel fine.
A bit over 210.
There we go. 210 years later. Damn, I look fine for being like 240.
Codsworth, you're acting...
Let's see if I can't get him to confide in me. Yay! Got it!
It's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed. Nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood.
That is tragic.
Get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car, the car.
Poor robot's having a mental breakdown.
Whoa, whoa. Focus, Codsworth.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, Mum. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were... dead.
No, not dead, just
have
frozen.
You this holiday? I believe Sir was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? Sir and young Sean may turn up yet.
Oh...
All right.
Let's just humor this robot. Because I feel bad not humoring him, and I don't want to insult him. Let's see if we can, to see if he can find us anyone or anything. Oof. We'll take the... Whoa!
I dare say I'm slightly disappointed.
And a toaster.
My senses are picking up movement in another house. Follow me!
Lead on, my robot companion! Lead on, I follow diligently. Show me what you find. Oh, it's this house, huh? Well, I want to kill some things this time. Nope. There we go, got one. Oh! He's too fast for me. He's still too... Whoa. There we go. Well, there's only one of us.
Codsworth.
Miss Rosa, Sir and young Sean.
That would be correct, Codsworth.
Sean's out there, Codsworth. I need to find him.
And I will find him.
And your people there. And last I checked, they only pummeled me with sticks a few times before I had to run back home.
Let's give him the...
Codsworth.
Good luck.
Yes, I will. Oh, right. Well, we will be going and investigating that. I want to just run over here and drop some stuff off, if I can, in the workshop. Oh. So let's get out of that. We're going to transfer all the junk I picked up. And is there anything else I want to transfer? Anything else I don't need? I don't really need a new jumpsuit there. And, you know, £17 is not bad. £17 is not bad to carry. So, I am going to finish up this video here. I do hope you're enjoying this. Do tune in to see if we can't find our little darling baby boy and seek revenge for the murder of our dear husband. So if you enjoyed this, give us a like, comment, subscribe. Please come back. It's going to get much more interesting now that we're going to get into some real combat situations. And as always, ladies and gentlemen, have a good one.